Arthur?
What is happening here, Mr. Morgan?
Mr. Strauss?
Arthur. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Well, we ain't done yet, Abigail. Dutch seems
to have lost his mind, and no.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.
I'm so very frightened.
Of what?
Of everything. This cannot go on. How many more times will we survive? These past months have been hellish.
Have they? For me, they've been different. I'm a changed man, Herr Strauss, entirely changed. I have been saved from hell.
We are going to die.
Of course. Not
yet. You okay, Arthur? Sit down. Please.
You brought the head.
I'm fine.
You don't look fine.
Well, I had some bad news.
Was it Mary?
No, not exactly. That's me. I'm sick.
Sick?
Yeah. I might die.
Oh. I'm so sorry.
Yeah. Me too. Me too.
Maybe you'll get better.
I don't think so.
Then I'm sorry.
Only the thing is, since then, I've started seeing things differently. I don't know what I'm trying to say here.
It ain't over till it's over.
Hi.
All right there, Arthur.
Arthur!
Susan?
Someone smashed the box!
What box?
The money box! We'd had that for so many years!
Why did they smash it?
I don't know. Look at this place. All divided. Everyone anxious and at each other's throats. I'm heartbroken.
Yeah, me too. Me too.
What the hell's going on around here? Dutch is crazy as a cat.
Rick and Bill are turning all kinds of screws on me. The only way this is going to end is with a big old hole in Uncle's head.
Arthur? Hello.
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape, yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation. The main house and all it stood for are thankfully no more. Yours faithfully, Penelope Braithwaite.
What is it?
Ayúdame.
You gotta be real dumb. I don't get you, my cousins will.
Lousy bastards.
J. John Weathers.
They call me Snow Goose now.
Whatever they call you. You borrowed money off of Leopold Strauss. The bills come due.
This ain't the best time, sir.
This ain't the best time for anyone.
Mr. Strauss knew it was a long-term proposition.
The debt is due.
Okay. I got supplies meant to last through the winter. You can take them. Just, is there any way you can help me? I stay out here, there won't be anyone to pay you.
I ain't here to help. I'm here to collect. We're all of us up against it.
Look, there's men after me. They're killers. I ain't a deserter, just an objector. It ain't right. If there was another way than running, I need your help.
Shut up.
Please. I...
Up here, it's him.
It's too late.
Form up, we shoot on sight.
I clear off, sir.
Shit. Well, seeing as I'm here, I'll do what I can for you. Should have helped you fix the damn wagon.
We could probably still save something.
Really now?
Look, you can take the silver locket for the debt.
Fine. Now, go. Get her somewhere safe. Go on.
Thank you, feller. I don't know where we can go, but I'll try. Pray for us.
We're past praying, boy. Hey, boy.
Can you help? Can you help me, mister?
What's the problem?
My goddamn horse got spooked and run off.
You hurt?
Not too bad, at least. But he took my damn leg.
Sorry.
He went that way, I think. His name's Buell.
Buell?
Second time a prick named Buell cost me a leg.
Huh?
Buell was my general when I lost it.
Okay.
Anyway, if you see an angry bastard of a horse with my wooden leg, I'd be real grateful.
I'll bear that in mind.
Thank you.
easy. Just come on.
Calm down. Take it easy. Calm down. Okay. Come on now. Thank you.
Easy, easy. Easy now. Easy. Easy, whoa. Come on. Just come on. Go easy.